So yeah, great times, man. Great fucking times. So yeah, if you get a chance, go on to YouTube and watch the first two episodes of Cobra Kai. It's a new, it's a Karate Kid spinoff. It has the original Johnny Lawrence, who his name is William Zabka, and Daniel LaRusso, Ralph Macchio. And they make some, they pay homage to Mr. Miyagi in the show. They talk about Allie, and of course she doesn't make any type of appearance except for in old nostalgic clips, and I think they show her Facebook page. I know that they said something about her Facebook and all this shit and how Daniel's been stalking her over the years. But that's just, I mean, that's not actually what happens. That's just how I thought, you know, this motherfucker's been stalking her since she broke up with him for the quarterback of UCLA or whatever the fuck it is in part two. But anyway. So next, I'm going to play some tunes. One of them is a special tune. It's a dedication, but I'll let that be known after. But here is my buddy Leo from Switzerland with his version, his metal version of A-ha's Take On Me. And check it out here at the Prickly Rickly Show at rockmetaltalk.com, brought to you by Mr. Jay Stone from Tappan Springs, Florida. Oh.
Talking away, I don't know what I have to say. I say it anyway.
to fuck too. If you wanna fight, then I'll fight you. If you wanna fuck, I will fuck you. Make up your mind, oh, I'll make it up for you.
back. It's Prickly Rickly here at the Prickly Rickly Show at rockmetaltalk.com. What you just heard was my alcoholic friends from the band Dresden Dolls. And I want to personally send out that to an ex of mine. We just got reconnected on social media here recently. I don't know. I'm not sure how she found me. I think it was through another friend, you know, because Facebook does that whole, you know, recommendation of friends and all that shit. So, and it's really cool because I've been trying to find her as well, but I, you know, her name is so unique that, you know, I never knew. And plus she had gotten remarried and all this shit, so we talked from time to time. And so Val, that song was for you. I promised that I would play some Dresden Dolls a couple weeks ago, but then I got hit with these interviews, so I didn't have time to put them in to any of my, you know, my show or whatever. So, and this happens to be one of the songs that I like by them. It's very different musically, but lyrically, it's some pretty fucking morbid shit. I mean, if you really listen to some of the Dresden Dolls lyrics, wow. I mean, it's pretty fucking morbid. It's very gothic, but it's not as gothic as, you know, as the media or whatever promotes gothism or whatever the hell. But it's a very gothic type of sound. But I dig it. It's pretty cool, man. If you ever get a chance, you guys just listen to some Dresden Dolls, and it's different. I think you'll like it. I like it. It took a second for me to get into, but I remember when we were younger, she would tell me that she loved the Dresden Dolls, and, you know, I was more of a metalhead, like, you know, type shit, and, you know, I didn't want to get outside my comfort zone. But, you know, as you get older, you tend to want to stray away from that, you know, your old self and your old likings and shit, like music and stuff.